Go ahead, Joe.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm busy. Don't bother me.
Oh, yeah. Welcome to the Dumbass Club with host Rick Fairless and his friend JoeT.
That would be me.
Yeah. More like Ed McMahon.
Hey, please.
Do not
I'm doing prep work here. Don't bother me.
Don't bother me during my solo performance.
I'm ignoring your solo performance.
I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I was led my dear Savior in.
That's for Troy.
Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw. Notice I throw a little yodel in there like Hank does.
I'm ignoring
I saw
you.
The
I'm
light.
Ignoring
I saw the light. Please. No more darkness. Little Ricky's looking at you,
I'll
Joe.
Start with that.
And
I'm
he
busy.
Don't like it either.
I'm doing show prep. Don't bother me.
We're on the air and you're doing show prep.
Well,
I saw
I gotta do it sometime.
Okay.
Play that out.
This is the Rick and JoeT Dumbass Club coming to you almost live from almost downtown Dallas.
Wait a minute.
How many times did I tell
you
I wanted to be...
Did you hear that?
If I get a job on Sirius, I'm hiring a new friend.
Nobody will put up with you.
Well, that's why I said I'll hire one.
Plus, nobody else has got a phone that can Google and do...
Bet me buckwheat.
Deal. Not as good as I
Let
am.
Let me start over again. Pretend like you're just a professional minion, okay? you just sit there and be a minion till I call your name.
No,
don't say a word until I call your name.
No such thing as professional minion. You know, Bundy's got
invented a professional minion.
Bundy's got a little shirt that's got a minion face on it. You know what the minions are? Have you seen Despicable Me?
No, that's a minion show.
No. It's a movie. It's a cool little movie, and the minions are on there.
A minion is like a dope.
Well, I know, but he's got
a minion,
whole bunch of little dope.
See, I have minions do my bidding, Joe.
Is that what it is?
It's true. Minions do my bidding.
Uh-huh.
Let me start from the top. Pretend like you're a professional minion, and don't say nothing. Don't push no buttons.
I'm running the board. Go ahead.
He'll never make it.
Go ahead.
Here we go. This is the Rick and JoeT Dumbass Club coming to you almost live from almost downtown Dallas. We are in the CHUMP studios. We're the current... I knew you wouldn't make it. The current time is...
1:45.
Thank you. I am R.L. Fairless Incorporated.
Okay.
And my minion is...
JoeT.
JoeT.
I am not a minion.
What does the T stand for?
Tim.
Joe Tim?
Yeah.
Is that what they called you in school?
You
What's your name? Joe Tim?
No, they called me Tim.
Where's the Joe come from?
You dumbass. You.
No,
you.
Your mama named you Joe.
Yes, I know,
but
she ignored it, and you're the one that brought it back up. You and your dumb kids.
Me and my dumb kids. Here's how this started 20 years ago.
Yeah,
I go to Joe T's office, and we always knew him as Tim.
Yeah.
Tim and Lisa.
Yeah.
So we knew Tim. Went to bike shows with Tim Moore. And so I'm at his office one day, and I see the little tag on his desk that said J, period, Tim Moore.
Right.
And I said, J, Tim Moore? And he said, yeah. And I said, what does the J stand for? And he said, Joe. And I said, your first name is Joe? He said, yeah. And I said, your middle...
You didn't even know that.
No, nobody knew it. I said, your middle name is Tim? And he said, yeah. And I said, why don't you go by Joe? And he said... I just go by Tim.
Mom and Dad just always called me Tim. That's what they called me. I mean, I didn't know. I wasn't big enough when I was like, when you're 6 months old, you don't know.
That's true. You don't know, Joe. I'll give you that, minion.
So they called me
Joe.
Tim, and I went, okay.
So they called him
I
Tim.
I stuck with it.
He stuck with it till I came along.
Yeah.
And then so I said, so they call you Tim, J. Tim. Well, that's your slave name, your working name, so your motorcycle name will be just the opposite. Instead of J. Tim, it's Joe T. And he said, do not call me that. And I said, oh, I'm going to call you that.
I should have never told you not to do it. If I'd have went along with it and said, oh, that's wonderful.
I'd have forgot about it.
You'd forgot about it, and I wouldn't have to deal with it.
So then I started calling him that. He said, Thank God nobody else calls me that. So then I got my kids calling him JoeT.
Yeah, I'd show up over at your house and Biggin coming out, Joe.
At 4 years old. Yeah,
she still does. That's what she did a while ago. Walked in your office, she comes in and hugs me. Hi, Joe.
That's because you're a family. You're a friend of the family, you
crazy
minion.
Kids. I blame your kids. See, if the kids hadn't done it, it'd probably faded away.
Why do you think your mom named you Joe?
I don't. My whole family kind of did that. Went by their middle name.
Hey, hold on, audience. I'm going to have breaking news. Joe Tim is the better of the name than his brother. His brother's name is Monty Tane.
Yeah.
T-A-N-E.
Yeah, I don't know where they came up with that.
Sounds like I'm lifting, doesn't it? Tane.
Well, you called, when Tane worked here, you called
him Monty. Monty T, Joe T,
yeah,
and Monty T.
Yeah.
Neither one of them got since the poor piss out of the boot, do you, Joe?
I'm doing okay.
You're doing okay.
I'm making a living.
So, we are brought to you by our sponsors, American Ice.
Yep.
The folks over at Bagger Nation.
And they literally sell ice. It's not like vanilla ice, like the rapper.
He's from Dallas.
I know, but he don't do nothing but just jack around. These people sell ice.
They're ice.
Yeah.
So if you're having a party or something and you want ice, you don't want to go to 7-Eleven and deal with the ragheads, call American Ice. Can you say ragheads on the radio?
I don't think so.
I done said it.
I don't think that's politically correct.
I didn't mean to offend any ragheads, so if you have any comments, please send them to 7204 Duffield.
No. I'm moving.
I know you are.
I assume you're thinking none of the ragheads listen to this show anyway.
I'm assuming there's no ragheads that listen to this show. But if they do, God love them. Right? Right, Joe?
What if they're motorcycle buyers?
Actually, we sold bikes.
You sold to a raghead already?
We sold to some Indian people from India.
Yeah.
When you say Indians, it's dot, not feather.
Yeah, I understand. I got it. I understand.
And you
I've
know
been
what?
Around you long enough. I understand.
They're very nice people.
Yeah.
I think everybody should have three or four of them.
Stop. Well, you know, that's the way I am about midgets.
I don't want no midget. I'd rather have a raghead.
Would you?
Yeah. You can go to 7-Eleven and get you a new one if you lose one. Where are you going to find a midget? Call a cab and you got a raghead, Joe. What do you want?
I don't know. Stop. They're going to throw us off of this. You own this show.
Meathead will come in tomorrow and say, well, you lost our sponsors.
you know about that sponsor thing? Never mind.
Never mind.
Yeah.
Okay. So American Ice, Bagger Nation.
Our buddy Paul Yaffe.
Buddy Paul Yaffe at Bagger Nation's got the coolest motorcycle parts on the planet. Yep. And
a nice wife, too.
A beautiful, nice wife. They smoke cigarettes, though.
Do they?
She does.
You know, that's right.
She does, and I think he does, too. And I'm sure you're listening to the show, Paul, since you're a sponsor. Quit smoking. Fat people should not smoke. Do you smoke, Joe?
No.
Joe, don't smoke. Fat people are not supposed to smoke. So if you're fat, quit smoking. If you're skinny, light one up, brother.
You're skinny. You don't smoke.
No, I'm thinking about taking it up.
Are you?
Yeah. Uh-huh. You know, there's lots and lots and lots of lots of people smoke, Joe. Graveyards are full of them.
You know, taking it up, you know, might be better for me in the long run.
Taking it kills you slower, though.
Yeah, that's true.
Might kill you quicker.
Yeah. Your mom stopped smoking, didn't she?
She hadn't smoked in over a year.
That's good. I'm proud
and then,
of your mom. She smoked like 80 a day.
Can you hear me talking?
Not really.
She didn't smoke 80 a day.
She
that's four packs.
She smoked a bunch every
How many
day?
Cigarettes are in a pack?
I don't know.
20 or 30?
No idea.
25?
Every time I saw your mom, she had a cigarette in her hand.
Yeah, I know.
I'm just glad she quit.
And then Bert Baker at Baker
Transmissions. A genius.
Yeah.
Genius guy.
We've got a couple of new sponsors coming on.
Really?
Yeah.
Can you mention their name yet?
No, because I ain't got any money. I ain't mentioned no names, so I got, where's my money? That's when I mentioned their name is when I got the money.
So that all four of our listeners understand that we have new sponsors.
Yeah. Actually, I got, you know, we put out that challenge to tell what an RCH is.
Oh, I got the email.
Guy was from from Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
And his name was Rick something.
Yeah.
Rick in Pennsylvania, I'm coming to you. You won't come see me. You won't come to Muhammad. Muhammad is coming to the mountain.
What is wrong with you?
I am. You're coming to see him.
Who? When?
July.
What if he don't want you to come see him?
Too late. Giving him fair warning.
Because if you call me and say, I'm coming over, I go, oh, I got to go somewhere.
He pulls
I'm busy.
He pulls the shades down and locks the doors.
Turn off the lights. Hide behind the couch.
When he hears me knock, he makes everybody, he puts his hand over Bundy's little mouth.
Bundy, don't say nothing. It's Uncle Ricky. Don't say nothing.
I'm going to the Roar on the Shore, which is a big rally on Lake Erie.
Oh, yeah.
In Erie, Pennsylvania. And it's July 20, 21, 22, something like
that. How long are you going to be up there? Just a couple of days?
Well, you know, but you've got to fly there. It takes a day, and I'm there 2 days, and I fly back. So, yeah. And I'm going to be at Action. Hold on. Biggin! Where's my little bell? You remember I used to ring that bell and Megan would come running?
Yeah.
You know, and get
you need that for Biggin now.
Yeah, and get it. She's too surly. And Megan was too. You remember? And get a refreshment for my guests?
Yeah, that's right.
So anyway, I don't remember the name of the store, but the people are really nice. It's a Victory dealer there in Erie.
Oh, cool.
So
are they having like a big party for the weekend or something?
Yeah, and then the rally. So okay. I'll be at his shop, and I'll get Biggin to tell me the
I remember you telling me about this. Yeah.
So I'll be there.
When is that?
That is in July 2021, something like that.
So somebody's up in Pennsylvania.
What's the name of the place I'm going in Pennsylvania?
Off-Road Express Victory.
Off-Road Express.
In Erie, Pennsylvania.
I got that. Beat it. Off-Road Express Victory in Erie, Pennsylvania is where I'll be. I'll be there on Friday all day with the Victory truck and signing autographs and talking to people. And then on Saturday, I'm leading a ride from Off-Road Express Victory to Roar on the Shore.
So if anybody in the area, they ought to come by.
Yeah.
Yeah, come by and see you.
Come by and see me. But
so we got one listener. Where's he from? I didn't notice where he was from.
It said PA. He said NPA, RCH stands for.
Yeah.
And then
Red.
Now you just got to throw that out, huh?
Well, this is the first.
Just got to throw it out.
I'm giving him a hint. For the people that don't know, I'm giving him a hint.
The other three guys don't care because they didn't email me.
Well, I know Troy knows because I think he's emailed us that before.
Troy hadn't emailed me. He hadn't seen the last show yet.
Yeah. Okay. Well, he will.
Well, he's been traveling.
Has he? I was traveling yesterday. I was in Atlanta.
Maybe he'll play golf. Are you going to play golf in Sturgis?
Yeah. What else am I going
to tomorrow, June 16th, day before Father's Day, is Tim's birthday.
That's true. I'm accepting gifts.
He's accepted.
But there is a minimum.
I call him by a slave name.
For my birthday?
Yeah. Oh. For your birthday, I called you by
that's your present to me? That's about what I'll get
Hey,
for
when
me.
We were golfing with your lawyers and they kept calling you Tim, I said Tim one time and you were fixing the tee off and you said, don't call me Tim. It sounds weird.
Well, I'm so used to the other from you now. You mouthing off about that crap. Yeah.
So JoeT will be 56 years old.
Yeah.
Damn, you're going to be old.
Well, you'll be that old in September.
Someday, you're right. Someday I will be 56.
It's in September.
Which September?
This coming September.
Well, I don't like to brag, Joe, but that's younger than you.
Well, 3 months.
Okay. You don't think three months is a long time?
No.
Stand on your head for 3 months.
It's not.
It's forever.
It's not. It's not. It happens that quick.
Yeah, I know. My whole life happened that quick.
So we playing golf tomorrow? Rand's in town. What's Rand doing in town?
We got his trailer here. You know, we did some work on his trailer, and then we tuned up his two bikes.
So he's just coming up to get them?
Yeah, he's coming up
When's he coming in? Tonight?
Yeah.
Okay. Where are you playing? Tomorrow?
Water Chase.
Okay.
Now, there's going to be five of us. We're playing a fivesome.
Who else is playing?
Bowman and then his – you played with Bowman's buddy, right? The big investment guy?
Yeah. What's his name, Dave?
Richard.
Richard. That's right.
Bowman told me he's the president of whatever the name of that company is. And Bowman said they will not take your money unless they take money in $10 million increments. Mm.
So that's like walking around money for you.
Do investment firms, are they some that's only will only take it in that small amount?
Yeah.
Are they specialized in what they, like you do, you only do land?
Yeah.
Is that the same kind of deal you think?
No, I think he's probably doing individuals. And I mean, I don't know what he does particularly, but yeah. I mean, there's a lot of firms, I mean, that won't make investments that are smaller than, I mean, the smallest investment they'll make is $50 million. Right. If it's below $50 million, they don't even want to talk to you.
Right.
See, I'm a more small deal. I mean, I'll do stuff from, I mean, the most of my stuff is the $5 to $10 million range.
I had a guy call me yesterday. You know, I told you that it almost, this is a fact, almost every week, one person calls me or emails me or contacts me about opening up a Strokers.
Well, that's since you opened this place you've had, though.
Right, for all these years. So a guy calls me yesterday, and he's a guy that I'd met years ago, and he said, yeah, I'm working at, and I don't even remember, some motorcycle shop outside of Longview or Abilene or somewhere, you know, a pretty small town.
Okay.
And we had a meeting, and we've decided that we want to partner up with you and have you do a Strokers down here in our town. Like, I was going to say, oh, God, y'all.
I can't wait.
Y'all want to do it? Man, this is going to be great.
So they decided it was a good idea.
Yeah, they decided it was a good idea. Okay. And he said, because he didn't ask me. He told me that's what they were going to do. And he said, I was wondering if Saturday would be a good day for me and my partners to come up and sit down with you. Yeah. And I said, no. And he said, Saturday's not a good day. And I said, I ain't going to do that deal. And he didn't say anything for a minute. And he literally thought I was crazy. And he said, why wouldn't you do it? I mean, look at the opportunities of the money you can make. And I said, and I believe this to be true. I truly think that's one of the reasons I've been, I mean, I'm not successful
you are.
I'm in my industry, I'm very successful. And I think it's because I don't give a shit about the money. I could care less, as long as I'm making enough money to you know, to live my lifestyle, which is not very fancy, I'm good with it.
Well, sure.
I mean, I'm thinking, okay, so if I made double what I made now, what would I do different? Nothing. What, I go out and buy me a new?
Well, no, what you'd do different is if you had two places, you'd have two headaches with employees.
And that's what I tell them. My standard line is I have all the headaches I can stand right here in Dallas. Why I won't go somewhere else? Right.
Well, and two, you and I have talked about this. We've talked about this, but you don't really want to trust your name to somebody else.
No, because my name's all I got.
Right. Well, and that's what, I mean, people think of this place, it's called Strokers, but they think it is Rick Fairless's place. And we talked about that when we changed the name from Easy Riders.
Right.
I said, you need to put your name on it. I said, call it Rick Fairless's whatever.
And that's what it is, Rick Fairless
we
Strokers
should have
Dallas.
It whatever. Rick Fairless's whatever.
Whatever.
Strokers.
Yeah, we should have. Okay, Joe. How you doing with that?
So, anyway.
So.
No, I understand. I mean, I wouldn't want somebody else running my business. And if your name's on it and you're part of it, you can't do that.
Right. No, I mean, you know, I mean, could you make a lot more money and be, you know, traveling and doing different things and all that? Yeah. You know what I think to myself? I'll leave that up to Biggin. When she owns a place, she can do what she wants.
Right.
She can, after I'm gone, she can open up 100 of these places.
Yeah, like McDonald's. There'll be one in every town.
Hey, you know what they say about how you can tell a driver's from Texas?
What?
He got one hand on the steering wheel, one hand on his shotgun, and throwing the McDonald's wrappers out the window.
Which hand's he doing that with?
Don't ask, Joe.
Hey, you want to see a picture of Jessica Simpson's butt?
Is she got big or is it little?
It's still pretty big. Look. If you don't know, we love Jessica Simpson. We love Pam Anderson, and we love Jessica Simpson.
I love her a long time. So she's getting kind of big. Well, she's
pregnant. Had a baby.
Oh, yeah.
She had the baby.
Right.
But this is post-baby, but she hadn't lost the baby weight yet.
She will.
Yeah.
She's a good-looking woman.
Yeah.
So, on...
So what else is going to... We talked a little bit about the chump trip last time. We went to Santa Fe and played golf with friends and with Ann. And had your golf tournament. Then you played in a golf tournament with me.
Right.
You know what won that golf tournament?
You told me.
We shot.
We covered this the other day.
I know, but I verified it now. We shot a 59.
Right.
Which is, I mean, what's that? 18 under par, something? I mean, You know what won that tournament?
That's like 11 or 12 under par.
You know what won?
10 less than us.
46. Can you imagine shooting 18 holes with 46 strokes?
Cheaters.
That's amazing.
I'm sure they cheated. They're cheated trying to win that $50 trophy.
I think they had a ringer on their team. Because I know Jay is on that team.
Right.
And he's not even better than me. He's not as good as me and you. So they had to have a couple of ringers on there that were just...
Okay, Joe, here's some...
What?
Some cards that Hallmark wouldn't print. You know Hallmark, the card company?
Yeah. What? Is this like a new deal we got? Is this a bit?
Well, I'm just working them in because we're not organized.
Well, I know that part.
I might organize this, Joe. Well, first of all, let's talk about what we're trying to do. We're trying to get on... Yeah. XM Sirius.
Yeah. Now, tell them what happened on that, though. I mean, you called me at home last night.
Well, I'm fixing to. Okay. But see, you got to shut up.
Wait. Let me. I'm trying to get some mood music.
Boys, what is going on in here?
Oh, that ain't it.
That's a midget song.
There you go.
Puff.
Yeah.
Puff. Okay, so.
I hate Puff, you know.
I know. Puff don't like you either. He don't like bald-headed guys. This is Peter, Paul, and Mary.
I don't like either one of them.
There's three of them.
I don't care. I don't like either one of them.
Meathead, Gary Rosin.
Yeah.
I've known him for 30 years. Gary Rosin.
Went to high school with him, didn't you?
Yeah, actually, I've known him more than 30 years, probably 40 years. Damn, he's old.
Yeah.
He's selling sponsorships and stuff. So, you know, I've mentioned to him that I wanted to try to take this show to...
Which one of these? Turn this down just a little bit. I want him to get the full effect of this story.
To XM or Sirius, you know, and at which I think they're the same company.
They are. They merged.
So he's got a buddy that's what he does. So he sent my buddy over just a short tape. Or his buddy over a short tape. His buddy thought we were funny.
Of me and you yakking like this?
Just like this.
Okay.
And then,
that's amazing to me that people think that's
just
funny.
Well, I think looks ain't everything. So then he wanted to hear some more. So we made we took some clips from when we were at 105.3.
Yeah.
With the professional entry and all that.
Yeah.
And then we took some clips from the Dumbass Club and we sent them to him. And he liked them. He told Meathead that he liked him, and he'd be in touch. And then yesterday he texted Meathead and said, "So-and-so from Sirius is coming in to meet with him."
Do we know how high up so-and-so is?
No, it was a text.
So it could be the janitor.
It could be.
Okay. Just check.
Who do you want listening to your stuff anyway, Joe?
Anybody.
Herman Munster?
I'll take anybody.
Well, okay. Right
we
now.
We only got like three now, maybe four.
Okay.
Okay. So if we can go to like, think about this. If we can go
Why
to
Why you
six,
interrupt me while I'm telling
I'm
this?
I'm just telling you. If we can go to six, that's a 50% increase.
I think we're already up to 10 or 11.
Oh.
You're not in touch with the real world.
Please.
So he said that he had a guy from Sirius coming in to talk to him next week.
Yeah.
And that
this song
he would take care of it from there. He would take care of it from there.
Okay.
Now, the chances of us getting on Sirius Radio are about the same chances
as
me banging Pam Anderson. But I'm working on it. I'm working on it, Joe. If I get on Sirius Radio, I can make millions, Joe. Millions.
Millions of what? We had this discussion before we came in here. Millions of what?
Maybe I get millions of minions. What do you think about that? Millions of minions.
You've got 50 million minions that work for you now.
Right.
How many of them would you want hanging around?
None.
Okay. There you go. So what are you going to do with millions of the
same
kind of group?
Actually, I don't know that there's any employee that I have that I don't care for.
I
think I like them all.
I know.
I really do.
But the question is, do they like you?
To my face, they do. As long as they do. You know what? And this is the way I've always been. I don't care if my employees like me as long as they respect me.
Oh, they do.
I mean, because I'm not going out and drinking beer with them and going to the horse races.
You're working.
I'm working with them.
There was a time that I actually thought your name was Rick Asshole.
Just because that's what they called me?
Say, oh, Rick, all right. Yeah, oh, yeah. And then I realized, now I get it. Okay.
So, Who knows? We may be on, we may get a
deal. Yeah, well, you four guys that are listening, send emails to Sirius and say you'd like to have the Dumbass Show on XM.
But how do they spell that Sirius? It's not Sirius.
It's S-I-R-U-S.
Sirius.
Sirius.
Sirius
slash XM. I don't know if it's XM slash Sirius, but it's one.
So wouldn't that be cool?
That'd be really cool.
But you would have to make the commitment of doing the show.
What is wrong with you and Meathead? Y'all keep going.
Because you don't show up near as much as you used to. It's like on Valentine's Day 2011, JoeT's son was born, and I lost my best friend on the same day.
I'm here all along. You gained a grandbaby.
Well, I'm good with that. Okay. That part of okay. I'm happy with.
You were there that morning. You held him.
I did.
You
I think I held him twice since then.
You saw how cute he was.
Yeah.
He's just getting cuter.
I want one just like him.
Okay. Anyway.
My old lady won't give me one.
You get us on there.
So I'm taking applications.
I'll be here. The question is it every day? Is it once a week?
Well,
is
who
it
knows?
On Tuesday night at midnight?
Well,
that'd
just
be
like
a good slot
just
for us.
Like I said, I think the chances of it happening are slim to none.
Yeah.
But
stranger things have happened. You actually have had two TV shows. Now,
and
what are the chances of that?
Well, I've had two TV shows, plus I also starred in an episode of the Biker Build-Off.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you know what? I'm doing another episode of Storage Wars on Wednesday.
Are you?
Yeah.
Are they bringing in?
Some motorcycle parts that they bought in one of them storage units. And you know what the lady said?
What?
She said, our executive producer wanted me to ask you if it's okay – could you please have your mom there so she could give them a rash of shit?
Is mom going to show up?
Yeah.
Are you? Oh, cool.
She works for me. She'll be here.
That's true.
So me and mom
She's
be...
one of your minions.
No.
Don't tell your mom.
No. No.
Yeah, let me call Sharon and say, Sharon, did you know you're a minion?
No, she's nobody. She don't know what a minion is. Ma, you're not a minion.
She wouldn't
trust me.
Yeah.
So, we're going to be on an episode of that.
Oh, that's cool.
You know what? I saw on Allstate deal where they had some pictures of my bikes in Laconia.
Yeah.
And most of the people love them, you know.
Yeah.
But, you know, of course.
You mean my bike.
Your bike and Betty.
Yeah.
And Betty's there too. Betty, yeah. The Betty bike and then.
The Allstate bike.
The Allstate bike that you bought. There's, like, you know, a bunch of comments and most of them are positive, but then there's the ones. Oh, no fenders and no front brake. You can't ride that piece of junk. And people say, oh, it looks like somebody threw up in a McDonald's bag. Different things like that. And then some guys will write on there, hey, Rick's a good guy. This is his art expression. And that's exactly right. I did not build that bike, or I do not build some of my bikes to be, you know, to ride from here to Sturgis.
No.
But as you know, a couple of years ago when we took Pam up there, I rode her exclusively, the same kind of bike,
sure,
over 1,000 miles that week.
Yeah. Well, it's rideable.
It's very rideable.
Just your butt hurts after a while.
Your butt hurts after a while. It's a bar hopper.
Yeah.
So to the people that think that the paint job's ugly and all that, we're all different, man. I mean, it's not just that we aren't all the same. So the guy, you know, one guy said, screw this, it's ugly piece of shit. He's going all that. And he said, I'll stick to my panhead chopper. And then I noticed his girlfriend commented the same thing. Oh, your panhead chopper? I got a panhead chopper too. What do you got? I got more of. Whatever you got, whatever that asshole's, it's just it pisses me off,
so
those pricks.
About?
It's just those pricks want to. They want to get behind that keyboard and run down somebody else's stuff.
They don't have nothing else to do. They got a lot of free time.
Well,
that means they don't got no job.
It's under Allstate Motorcycle. Go under that under Facebook, and you'll see some pictures, and you can flip through there and see some of my bikes. And those assholes that go in there that's fugly, you know what fugly means.
Yeah, I know.
It's fugly, trash. One guy called me, obviously didn't know who I was, called me a dirt bag. And it's just like...
Don't let those people bother you. Well, then think about it. Think about how intelligent they are. I mean, you and I could not have a more opposite taste in motorcycles.
Right.
But I appreciate what you do. They're not smart enough to do that. You like what you like. It's like me saying, you know, your yard's ugly. And you go, well, your yard... I mean, it's your own personal taste. You're not building those for me.
Right.
I build bikes for me. You build bikes for you, and you build what you like.
Well, it's
and it's art.
It's an expression of your art. And I'm a child of the 60s and 70s like you. Uh-huh. But I like the...
I just grew out of it.
You did. You did.
That's the difference. I grew out of it.
No, here's the difference. You were more into running track and playing football and all that. Well, I was into motorcycles. I was into to cars and motorcycles.
Well, I was, too. I mean, I've always loved it. But I'm just saying, but I build one style of bike, and you build a different style. But it doesn't make one better or worse or any different. It's just different styles. That's like Mondo builds a different style of bike than Arlen Ness.
Right.
I mean.
It just kills me. You do something. But the one thing is, my bikes stir emotions. Whether they're you hate love them or hate them. The people that see them in person can appreciate them because you can see the work.
The workmanship.
And you can see the different things that I've done, you know, but for some prick with a pan head chopper that's probably worth about $1,800 and his girlfriend on there to come on to a blog and write this thing on there about what an idiot I am and how ugly the bikes are. That ain't cool,
but
man.
I'll tell you, it's not cool. But I'll tell you, that happens to everybody. That happens to Arlen. That happens to Perowitz. It happens to Donnie. It happens to Yaffe.
But it ain't right.
It's
Had
not.
You ever gone on a website or got behind a keyboard and just run somebody down that you never met?
There was that time with Obama.
Well, I wouldn't even do that.
I'm just kidding. No.
You wouldn't either.
No, because I look at the motorcycles and I appreciate what they are. But I'll promise you, Arlen gets the same deal. There's people that don't like Arlen's bike, and there's people that don't like Yaffe's bikes.
Right.
You know, they go, you know.
When I read that.
I like them all. That's the difference in you and I, is we really do. I like them all.
I do like all bikes. I mean, I've owned as many Suzukis and Hondas as I have anything else.
I mean, right now, one of the things I'm really digging is all this cafe racer stuff. That Corey Nest, I mean, that Zach built out of the Victory. That is cool. And there's people that are just going to rag on that and hate that shit.
Well, that's not my style, and I would.
But do you appreciate it?
Yes, I think it's cool. I think that Victory the Zach Ness did is as awesome as any bike I've seen.
Yeah, I'd love to have one.
I would too.
I think that's neat as shit.
I mean, but that's not my riding style. But you know, the bike that I'm redoing now is a stretched out 20 over Pat Kennedy chopper.
But like I say,
with
the
Sugar Bear front end on it.
Think about how different that Ness bike is that Zach just built than what you're building.
Right.
But
they're both cool.
That's my point. They're both cool.
Right.
My problem is I can't afford to have everything.
Well, if somebody wants to get on there and rag me on the computer, show me what you got. Show me your pan head chopper. I might just think it's the greatest thing ever invented. And it may be.
Right.
That still don't give you the right to put me down or put other people down.
Right.
If I see something I don't like, you know, if I see a $200 car on eBay, I'm not writing a guy a letter and telling him what. And so you know what I did? I went to that guy's Facebook.
Yeah.
And maybe you know how to do it, or I can get big into.
I wanted
to see where you can send them a message. But can you send them a message if they're not your friend?
Yeah. I don't know.
I couldn't find it. I wanted to send that guy a message that said, you know, and I wouldn't say anything ugly.
Right.
You know, here I might, but in person I might. But over the, I was going to say, I'm sorry you don't like my bike. I built this bike for me, and I built this bike to bring attention to Allstate.
Yeah, they wanted it, and Allstate wanted you to build. That's the reason they picked you, is they wanted something with your style.
Allstate wanted me to do one with my signature psychedelic paint job, and that's what I enjoy doing. You know, so
they wanted Arlen to build his style, and they wanted Perowitz to build his style.
Yeah, so
I don't get it.
The guy with the pan head chopper. I love pan head choppers. I've had one for 30 years, prick.
You do.
I do.
Actually, mine, you got...
There it is right there.
I know. I told you, when something happens to you, that's the only thing I want. I want that back.
Well, you were going to give me what? You were going to give me your 56 when you died, and then you sold it.
Well, I got the ambulance. Now you got my bike.
I don't want your ambulance.
You don't?
Not
actually,
really.
When I move in a couple of weeks, I'm going to come get it and take
Thank
it
Thank you.
I'm going to come get it take it.
What about that Triumph? Can you take it home, too?
No, I'm going to. I need to sell it.
You do. You need to sell that.
Because I'm not going to ride it.
But you're going to have to ask a reasonable price for it. Yeah. You know, we're having the NT, North Texas Norton Owners Association meeting up here on the 25th.
They've met here before.
This will be the third time. It's their third annual bike show.
I like those.
Maybe
guys.
You put it out there and you put a for sale sign on it.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, we ought to do that.
Those are good guys. So if you're in the area, come in then.
They bring some old Norton stuff.
But do me a favor and do the world a favor. Don't be one of those keyboard commandos or whatever they call them where you get on there and you run other people down behind the security of your keyboard. If somebody has a problem with one of my bikes, call me. You think my bike's ugly? Call me.
Yeah.
Tell me that. And if you don't got the balls to do that, then shut up.
Well, there's just no need for it.
It just pisses me off. Those pricks get on there and they start running.
It makes them look dumb.
It does.
It makes
them
look
dumb. You know, and they go into this big, that thing ain't got no fenders, that piece of shit, you can't ride that thing. I'll race you. What you got? What you want to do? You want to ride? I'll ride. I was riding before you were born, probably.
Well, you rode it. When you did your first bike like that, when you built the ones for the backer build-off, which was a big, long chopper, rode it from, where did we start at?
600 miles.
Well, out in the middle of nowhere in California, to Phoenix.
The Phoenix, yeah.
All down through the Salton Sea. And
It's that's just the style of bike that I like personally. Yeah. I build all kinds of bikes for all kinds of people, and whatever somebody wants, that's what we build. And guess what? No two people like exactly the same thing.
That's exactly right.
Well, I happen to like tie-dye, psychedelic kind of stuff, you know, because that's what I grew up with, and that's what makes me feel good. I remember being in school thinking, man, I wish I could grow my hair. I wish my dad had let me grow my hair out.
Yeah.
And then, you know, of course, you get out of school and you go to work. Well, grow your hair out. I remember thinking, oh, man, I wish I had a job where I could grow my hair. You know, when I worked at Glidden, my hair was long by sales rep standards.
Still didn't touch your shoulders.
No, it touched it touched the top of my shoulders.
Maybe in the back.
Yeah, it wasn't very long, but for being an executive or being a sales rep, it was long hair. Mm. And then, you know, so, I mean, I always wanted to have a beard and long hair.
Yeah, you got one.
Now I got
How's
one.
How's that working out for you?
Not so good.
How's that sex life holding up for you?
Sex life is the least of my interest, Joe. I could give a shit less about sex life.
Just means you're getting away till you turn 56.
Yeah.
Then you really won't give a shit.
I don't give a shit already. Hold on, my pocket's ringing. Maybe Troy Aikman or Pam Anderson.
Turn that off.
Oh, it's Herschel Walker.
Oh.
I better get it. Y'all can listen in.
Okay.
Hey, Herschel. Good. What's happening? Okay, you want me to come get it, or is Julie going to ride it up here? Okay. Okay, no, that'll be cool. So you and her will come up Saturday's afternoon or something?
Yeah, we'll just come up Saturday afternoon. I'll let her ride and stuff.
Okay, pal, that sounds cool, and then we'll get it. We'll get it.
And Mary may have a lot of work for you because she's been out really pitching you a lot.
Mary has?
A lot, so that's a good thing.
Yeah, she and she brought another guy out here, Chris, with a K.
Yeah.
And they were very, very, very nice, and I think they liked my place. I mean, you know, it's
well, they did.
Well, good. Yes. She bragged on you, Herschel.
Oh, geez, well, I've known Mary forever, so that's probably the reason why.
Well. Yeah, well, hopefully she can get me some speaking engagements. I wouldn't mind doing a couple of speaking engagements with you. You know, if we could do them and I could, you know, do some with you.
Now that'd be good.
Yeah, that'd be.
I can tell them you ought to do a truck thing on that.
Yeah, I would love to do that.
All right, so that'd be
Yeah, that would be cool. That way they could see how the big shot from won the Heisman Trophy and went to college, and then the little shot that went to MacArthur High School and went straight to work, and they both did it.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Yeah.
That could be great, man. I mean, you know, someone over 10
Okay, yeah, that would be cool. I'd love to do that. Okay, pal, so you're going to come up on Saturday?
Yeah, I get us, we can bring up down Saturday. Okay. Oh, you know what, who's the lady that you want to trade for this place?
Shauna,
oh yeah, all right. All right, man.
Okay, Hershaw, I'll see you on Saturday.
All right, thanks, man.
Thanks, bye.
There you go. I just put it on.
Hey, Herschel, you don't care if I put you on the radio, do you?
I was going to say.
No, he don't care. So that was the one and the only. Walker. You know what? I started to tell him that we're on the radio and then ask him, you know, kind of do like a little interview. But yeah.
You could barely hear it. I mean, you could hear it, but it wasn't.
Right, yeah. What we need to do? We just need to get him on here and do interviews.
Yeah.
Once we're on Sirius, I think we can do some interviews.
Actually, it'd be nice to have him up here with us one day. I mean, yeah. Herschel will come up here.
Yeah. Oh, he'll be here tomorrow. Herschel's a great guy. I've been doing business with Herschel for 20 years, 17 years.
Well, since you started the shop.
Yeah, 17 years.
I remember him first coming in.
There's nobody any nicer in this world than Herschel Walker.
Yeah, well, he was on the Kyle Petty ride this year. That's one of the things he's been buying bikes for you in the past. The last few years, he buys a new bike and he goes on the Kyle Petty ride.
Right. This year, he bought bikes for his brother-in-laws and his brother. They all bought Victories and they all rode on the ride. And
how'd they like those Victories?
They loved them.
Yeah,
absolutely loved them.
Yeah.
And it's just, you know, I mean, every little town we stopped at, you know, of course, the little towns know that we're coming.
Yeah.
And so they have some of them let the schoolhouse out and everything, and they're all waiting there at the deal. And, you know, they're Herschel Walker and Kyle Petty are signing autographs, and Herschel's signing a hell of a lot more than Kyle Petty.
Well, still, I mean, I'd love to have Petty's, but.
Kyle Petty is a super nice guy, too.
But that's cool. I mean, it's neat that Herschel does that.
How many times do you get to meet somebody that won a Heisman Trophy?
Yeah. Well, and it just is a great, great football player and a great person.
Yeah, he is a good guy. But what
amazes me about Herschel is he looks like he could play today.
I think he's in better shape now than when he played for the Cowboys.
Jesus Christ.
But what he's talking about with Mary is there's a lady, Mary Knox, that works for PPI, which is a marketing deal that is owned by Roger Staubach. It's owned by the Staubach companies.
Okay.
They represent a bunch of athletes for speaking engagements.
Yeah.
So Herschel recommended me to her because I love to do, you know, speaking engagements.
Yeah.
And her and some of her people came out and met with me a couple of days ago. And I showed them around, and they liked the place. And that's confirmation from him that he's talked to her, and she's been pitching me.
Oh, so maybe get to go and do
I mean, and basically, I give a speech, and I've lectured at DePaul University twice. You were with me. You were with me both times, weren't you?
Yeah, I've been both times.
You know what? They just sent me a deal. They're sending me tapes of that lecture.
Oh, really?
The second one, you remember, was in that big auditorium? Well, they're both in an auditorium, but that second one, you remember, they filmed it.
Well, and the first one was in kind of a
cafeteria.
A ballroom. It wasn't a cafeteria, it was a ballroom kind of deal. The second one was an auditorium.
Right. And you remember they had the deal there where they were filming everything?
Yeah.
So she sent me confirmation that they're sending me that. But, and I've spoke at TCU, and I'm speaking again at TCU in September. But I've also spoke to high schools and welding schools, and I've even spoke to.
Did you tell them you were a welding school dropout?
No, I graduated from welding school.
You did?
Yeah,
why can't you weld?
I could 30 years ago when I graduated, dumbass.
Has welding changed?
Yeah. At what?
Has it changed? Has welding changed? Why can't you
weld
today?
We did stick.
Okay.
They don't stick weld anymore.
No, we use MIG and TIG now.
Yeah. And we did a little bit of that.
Yeah.
But mainly what we did was stick weld. Yeah. We learned how to read blueprints.
Right.
And this was one of those manpower deals where they paid you like minimum wage to learn a trade, you know. And I went to welding school. Hmm. And then anyway, so Yeah, if I could get some speaking engagements, that would be cool.
That'd be cool.
Because basically what I tell them, I give them an hour speech, and at the end of it, the synopsis is, if a dumbass like me can be successful, anybody can.
For sure.
It's true.
Well, but your whole deal is
work
get
ethic.
Up every day, work hard, and good things will be all, it'll happen. It'll be fine. If you don't work hard, you're not going to get much.
And that don't matter who you are or how smart you are.
That's right.
If you don't work hard, you ain't got nothing.
Yeah.
So here's those Hallmark cards.
Okay, go
that
ahead.
That Hallmark would not print.
They wouldn't? Are you sure?
Let me get my cool rays on.
Is my wife going to give me one of these for my birthday?
Probably. Let's see. This is what Hallmark does not print.
Okay.
So your daughter's a hooker, and it spoiled your day. Look at the bright side. It's really good pay.
Okay.
Wait. Here's the one for you, Joe.
Hold on. Here's I got to find some.
Bessler! I saw him go by.
There he is.
I thought you were going to put Revolution on here, and you were going to make a deal, because this dumbass still doesn't
remember.
Know what those keys
chart.
He's been doing it for 5 years, and he has no clue.
I forget.
Well, I was looking for some number 2 pencils and crayons to make his chart.
Well, your kids ought to have all that. What about Revolution? You remember?
I just didn't get it on this week.
What have you been doing all week? Bessler? Beat it, Bessler.
You don't want to cut it like my wife. You don't want to cut into his nap time.
That's true. So here's another one. My tire was thumping. I thought it was flat. It wasn't. I ran over your cat. How's that one, Joe?
I don't like it.
Joe's a cat
These
person.
These are bad.
Hello. Hold on, Joe. Don't get excited about it.
I didn't.
You know, Joe, it's good to be a man.
Uh-huh.
Wedding plans take care of themselves.
Yeah.
Chocolate is just another snack. You can be president, Joe.
Yeah.
The world is your urinal.
You remember on the golf course?
Yeah, you just piss everywhere. I played golf with a woman before, and she said, I wish I was a man. I could just piss wherever I wanted to.
Did you tell her to go ahead?
I said, go ahead. We don't care. Same work, no pay, you know.
What is this you're reading? This is not a Hallmark card.
No, this is something else. I'm past that now. Let's see. You can open your own jars. Let's see. You're unable to see wrinkles in your clothes. You don't have to shave below your neck. Do women shave below their neck?
God, I hope so.
You don't have to shave below your neck.
Well, they got to shave their legs.
Oh, yeah.
Other stuff. Just call it other stuff.
Your belly usually hides your big fat hips. One wallet, one pair of shoes, one color, all seasons. It don't matter.
What? What is this crap?
I don't like to give away my secrets, Joe.
Jeez.
The whole world will be on. The whole world is my minions, Joe.
Your minions.
Okay, what else we got?
Have you already eaten lunch?
Yes. That's where I was when you texted me.
I know.
I thought you had 3 hot dogs by now.
I told you that I'd be over here, and we were going to go eat lunch.
You told me it was going to be around noon.
Okay. Isn't that where most people eat lunch?
Most people, yeah. What time do you eat lunch?
About 11.
Bingo!
I didn't get to eat lunch.
Bingo was his name.
I didn't get to eat lunch today.
E-I-O-B-I-N-G-O. Get you a couple of chili dogs, and we'll turn the golf tournament on. Watch it in my office.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
You can.
Oh, yeah, the U.S. Open's on.
U.S. Open.
Tiger was tied for second.
Yeah, I watched a little bit of it yesterday.
Have they? I guess.
You know what that Nick Watney, he made a double eagle.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. They showed
par two. I mean, a par five, he made a second shot.
Yeah, I saw it. Yeah.
And one guy the day before, which was in the Pro-Am round, there was somebody on the green, and they were still walking off the green, and he teed off. It's a par four, but it was only like 310 yards or something.
Short hole.
It is.
Short hole.
He made a hole-in-one on a par four, and so the guy's walking off.
An albatross.
An albatross. Well, that's what the other one was, too.
Right.
Double eagle.
Yeah.
The guy's walking off the green. He hears the ball hit behind him, and he stops, and he looks at it, and the ball rolls right into the hole, and he races. He's just some guy just walking off the green.
Jeez, that's amazing.
Isn't it?
Wouldn't you love to do that?
Oh, my God.
I'd just like to have a hole in one.
Hey, the other day I played with Bowman, and let me think. Bowman shot Bowman's pretty tough to beat. He shot an 85.
Did he?
Fairless shot 82.
Wow. You can tell how startled I am by that. That's the lowest score you've ever scored, isn't it?
No, I did that 80, remember?
Oh, yeah.
I did an 80.
Shot an 82?
Yeah.
Jeez, how many foot wedgies are in there?
I had two mulligans.
Yeah.
We played at Bridalwood.
Oh, okay.
Me and him and his wife.
Yeah.
She's real nice.
She a good golfer?
She said she broke 100, so she was happy about that. Yeah. You know what? I think she only plays three or four times a year.
Well, I thought they played all the time.
He does.
Well, I know he does, but I thought she played with him a bunch.
No, she's real nice, and she hits some really good shots.
Yeah.
But
we're playing Water Chase tomorrow?
Yeah, Water Chase tomorrow.
What time?
We tee off at 6. Okay. So you'll pick me up at 4:45.
Jesus Christ.
You never complain about
tired.
Getting up early.
I know, but I'm tired. I hadn't any sleep this week.
I ain't had any sleep in 40 years.
Well, that's true. I'm not going to argue with you.
I don't. I don't get no sleep.
Yeah. So anyway, then I got to be home. I got to start packing. We actually started packing boxes last night.
Did you hire a moving company?
Yeah. Yeah. They'll move all the big stuff and then the boxes, but we still got to pack all the boxes.
Did you hire the three Mexicans and a raghead moving company?
No, it's a white guy and two Mexicans.
It'll
take a little longer to move that way.
Yeah, the white guys can't do anything.
Well, he owns the company.
Well, no wonder it's a crummy company. You're getting a deal, ain't you?
Well, not really.
So, Joe, how are you and your wife getting along?
Let's talk about my new
Seriously?
Garage. Let's talk about my new garage. Let me tell you what I ordered
for my
garage.
I'd rather talk about your wife.
No. Talk about my new garage. Hey, I ordered one of those race decks. You know, the tile that you put down, a race deck tile?
Black and white?
No. I ordered it all yellow with a red border.
Oh, that's with those things like Big Dog when they sit out there
thing? Yeah. It's like that. My whole garage
snap
is going to be
covered.
My whole garage is going to be covered.
Shit, those things are probably $2,000, isn't it?
It's about that.
They're pretty expensive, but they're cool.
Yeah. But anyway, I can change it. But anyway, I got the whole garage going to be bright yellow.
How many car garage is it?
Three.
Please.
Yeah, I know. I can't step up
so
to
you're a minion, Joe. Yeah. Don't forget, minion.
I know.
So you're
going to stay below.
You're going to take that ambulance out of here?
Yeah. After I get moved in and settled, I'll come get it and my Victory. Take them home.
Yeah. What about your trailer?
No, I'm going to leave it here.
Okay.
Probably got your golf clubs in it still.
No, I'm using them. Hey, you know what I did last night? I was watching the basketball game, Go Thunder.
They lost last night, though.
Yeah, I know.
But they started out crappy.
They did two nights in a row, but the first night...
They came back.
They came back. Yeah. My wife said, how come you're for Oklahoma? And I said, honey, Charles Strand, hold on a minute.
Don't take that.
He's going to buy back from me. Hey, Charles.
Hey.
What's happening? Yeah. Yeah, I'm always here. You know that. That's it. Come on, brother. I'll be here.
I'll see you here in 30 minutes.
Okay, bye.
Okay, since you've already eaten lunch, I'm getting hungry.
That's Charles Strand. He used to own, he owned Iron Horse of Texas, and then he owned Renegade, remember, out there in Arlington.
You bought all of his stuff from him, Renegade, when he shut it down.
Yeah, he's looking at buying a Victory from me.
Oh, cool.
So anyway, what was I talking about?
We were talking about I'm putting race deck down.
That's going to be cool.
I think it's going to be neat. Yeah. They ship it next week. So I get it, and I got to stamp it into place, put it all in.
Okay.
That'll make my garage cool, don't you think?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it will. Hold on. What? Hold on. Here's my Mexican. What, you want my keys?
Yes.
Is it going to rain?
Who knows? You can wait for tomorrow. I'll do it tomorrow morning.
I'm going to play golf in the morning with my brother and my friend. Hey, guess whose birthday is tomorrow?
You getting me a present?
Yeah, we got it. It's a cheeseburger. You'll love it.
Don't listen to him, David.
You want to watch it today or tomorrow? Don't matter.
Tomorrow morning? Because we got a lot of things to do.
It may rain some more today.
Well, you have to watch it when I get back from playing golf.
All right.
It might be noon or 11 o'clock.
Okay, give me the key.
Okay, now you're talking.
Yeah. So So now you can get to wash it twice. It may rain again today.
No, he washed it yesterday. He may get to wash it three times. Okay. Pass that down. Don't race the motor, okay? I don't like nobody to race the motor in my truck.
It's a diesel.
Yeah.
It ain't going to race very much.
I got 110,000 miles on it. Yeah. How many's on yours? You don't drive yours no more.
I only got like 35,000 miles on mine.
Hmm. Yeah. Okay, put some exit music on. Let's blow this joint.
Okay, what are we doing? Oh, there you go. How's that?
That's Hank Williams. You don't get no better.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a good show.
Yeah.
But and then, if, like I say, we want to get on Sirius. So if you know anybody at Sirius, call them.
Joe,
send them an email.
Yeah.
They may have a Yahoo brother.
We also want to bang Pam Anderson. So if you know her, send her an email.
Yeah, if you're Pam's cousin and can get us in on that deal, we'll just ignore the restraining order.
Yeah.
So, I'd be willing to ignore the restraining.
Excuse me, I'm trying to sign off. Professional wise.
Please.
This has been the Rick and JoeT Dumbass Club.
Yep.
Coming to you almost live from almost downtown Dallas, where the current time is
1:45. It's always a 1:45.
Quarter till two in the CHUMP studios.
Yep.
I am Ricky Lee Fairless signing off.
With an E.
With an E.
With an E, right?
EY.
I didn't know that for years.
Ricky with the EY.
Yeah, I didn't know that. And I'm JoeT.
He's JoeT Moore signing off. Hey, feel free to shoot me an email and let me know how you like the show.
Yeah.
It's seriously, I read all my emails. rick@strokersdallas.com.
It takes him a while because he has to use his finger, but he'll get
How do them. You read emails?
Huh? I just read them. Like, I read them on my phone.
And it's because you got free time on your hands. Please.
I don't have any free time.
So send me an email. Check out my website, strokersdallas.com. We're making some cool victory parts, and we're starting to look at some Harley parts, too.
Are you?
Yeah.
How's your footboards coming?
They should be here today from the Cromer. They're already made, and we sold them to the Chrome shop.
Sold a few?
We haven't had any to sell yet.
Oh, well, that's true.
So we will.
Neat. Okay.
All right.
Let's get out of here.
See ya.
See you guys.
I'll see you on the radio. That may be my new sign off. I'll see you on the radio. You like it?
Yeah, I think it's been used.
See you on the radio.
Yeah, I think I've heard that before.
How about to the prick with the panhead chopper?
Turn this off before you get in trouble. Jeez. What do you got? Where's the guy with the panhead? What do you care about the guy with the panhead?
Try to stifle